the ASUS Vivobook S15 featuring the Snapdragon X Elite. The main reason I picked this laptop is for its impressive battery life, which I hope we get close to the advertised 18 hours. This will be a full review covering benchmarks, games, thermals, and also I will be doing a teardown and we'll check to see what we're able to upgrade. Last but not least, I will be testing out this Thermal Hero Liquid Metal Paste here on the Snapdragon X Elite, and we'll see the thermals before and after. Let's start with a quick overview of the specs. Inside we have the Snapdragon X Elite, specifically the X1E78100, and we get a 15.6 inch 3K OLED display, which is a 2880 by 1620 resolution, and up to 600 HDR peak brightness. With that, we also get Wi-Fi 7 support, and the overall weight is only 1.42 kilograms. When we're looking at the battery, we get a 3-cell 70 watt hour, and we also have a 90 watt AC adapter, which is included. Taking a look at the ports on the right hand side, we get two USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type A's here. Looking at the left hand side here, we get one HDMI 2.1 TMDS, and also two USB 4.0 Gen 3 Type C's, micro SD card reader, and one 3.5 millimeter combo audio jack. Looking at the keyboard here, we have a backlit chiclet keyboard with a one zone RGB with a 1.7 millimeter key travel. And we also get the number keys here, which I thought would feel kind of small, but they feel kind of perfect. I didn't have to kind of look when I'm typing numbers. I know right away what I'm pressing here. And just so you can hear the sound of this keyboard. And we also get a nice large touchpad here. The S15 also comes with a 180 degree lay flat hinge here, so it's able to do this. And this is how it looks like. The Vivobook S15 also comes with a full HD camera and with the infrared function to support the Windows Hello. And this is the quality you're getting. There are some features here which I will show you, like the studio effects. You can go ahead and portrait light here. There's like portrait background, as you can see. So we have standard blur as well, which does a pretty good job actually. And then we got some creative filters. You're able to apply those. This is the quality you're getting. And right now I have like full lights here. And this is pretty much what you're getting. Just before we go ahead and start the benchmark, so right now I do have the laptop plugged in and we have the power mode set to best performance here. So the first one here is going to be the 3D Mark Steel Nomad. So we get a score of 482 with an average frame of 4.83. Next we're running Time Spy here. Looking at Time Spy, we get a 1914 here with a graphic score of 1720 and a CPU score of 5310. Next, we're looking at the 3D Mark Wildlife 1.1. Looking at the 3D Wildlife score, we get the 19,574 with an average of 117.21 FPS here. Our next test is going to be the 3D Mark Night Raid. With Night Raid, we get a score of 26,366 and the graphic score is 28651 and the CPU score 18162. So right now we're gonna go ahead and run the Cinebench 2024 and we can see the thermals, and also I'm gonna go ahead and display the HW monitor here so you can kind of see like what's going on. In the end, I'll show everything so you'll be able to see the minimum, maximum here. Looks like the multi-core, it's 919.1
points here.
Now we're moving on to the Cinebench R23 here. Okay, we got the Cinebench R23 results here on multi-core. We have 10,962 points, and while on the single core, only 1,113 points. Next, we're running Crystal Disk Mark here just to see how fast this 512 gig SSD is. So we have the score for the SSD, and really nothing to brag about. 5,000 for read and 3,400 for write. So definitely I will be changing the SSD on this thing. Next, we're running the 7-zip benchmark here. The 7-zip benchmark here definitely got the fans going, and here are the total ratings. Right now we're gonna go ahead and run the Geekbench 6, and you can see the settings that I have here. Okay, we got the Geekbench scores here. So 2458 on a single core, and the multi-core here, we have 13,778. And those are the current scores. And here's some more information. So right now we have a benchmark going, and it's plugged in and it's set to performance mode. Just so you can kind of see like the temperature. So right now we're hovering at 46 here. Definitely a little toasty in the middle here. On the sides, it's pretty cool. And the touchpad here, it's not bad. And yeah, the sides are cool. The screen, it's all good. And just to kind of show you what's going on behind as well. So that's the exhaust here. We can see definitely that's doing its job. And going underneath here. And kind of seeing inside a little bit, like 54 Celsius there. So underneath, it's a majority of the like heat is like just around this area, the middle. The sides, it's pretty cool. So it's usually just like the middle portion that's kind of where the heat is. So right now we're gonna go ahead and run Rocket League here, and just to show you the settings that I'm using. So if I go under video, we have a resolution at 2880 by 1620. And these are the quality settings here. And the game here is definitely going at high frame rate. I'm not able to display the frame. I tried that, but just looking at it, it's definitely going well above 60 frames a second here, which is nice. No problems at all, like no glitching or anything else going on like that here. I did have the chance of playing a few matches here, so I did not experience any problems. And if you want to even like more frame rate, you can definitely go ahead and decrease the resolution or the quality, because I do have it at high right now, and it would run even smoother. Next, I'm running Alien Isolation here, and it does run pretty smoothly. I did have to adjust the settings though, just to show you some of the things I did here. So setting it at 1920 by 1080, so full HD, and the level of detail, I had to set it to medium. And there are some things that are like ultra here, particles that I left on, a few other things you can see here. And with these settings, I'm able to get some very decent frame rate, and it's definitely playable, as you can see here. There's like no glitching or anything going on. Definitely playable without any problems. Another game that runs really well on the Snapdragon X Elite is Grand Theft Auto 5 here. As you see, super smooth. Definitely, I'm not able to tell any like bugs or anything like that. Everything runs as it should. I did get the chance to play quite a bit on this, and everything went super smooth, as you can see here.
Now we're running Resident Evil 2 here, and looking at it under the graphics settings on resolution, I was able to set it to 1366 by 768. It won't allow me to go any more here, and some of the other settings, I will scroll down so you can kind of see like what I've set here. And it does run pretty well with these settings that I have right now. And just to show you. And right now, as you can see here, the game runs pretty smoothly. Like there's like a very good, decent FPS. At least I believe like it should be well over like 60 FPS here for sure. Probably even more. I'm not able to really check that live right now, but everything runs pretty smoothly. Sometimes there's like glitches here and there. Whenever like opening a door, going through a next stage and all that. But overall, it runs pretty smooth. Next, we're testing out LEGO Star Wars here. And you can see here, it tends to do a pretty good job, but it's dipping the 30 FPS sometimes. It's not running perfectly fine here. I was able to get it running a little bit more smoother under a lower resolution, because right now I do have it at 2880 by 1620. So that's the laptop's monitor resolution. So at 1080p, we are able to get some very smooth frame rates here, definitely playable, but at the higher resolution, it doesn't look so smooth. But 1080p, it looks very nice. And I think with this laptop, getting a game like this kind of makes sense, because even right now, like I'm putting my hand over the laptop, it doesn't really heat up, and you're probably playing with a controller too, so that shouldn't be really an issue. The fan is not going that high either, so the game runs pretty nicely. Next, we're going to look at some of the benchmarks for the Shadow of the Tomb Raider. And one thing I found very interesting is I kind of switched the resolution up and down here. So I currently have it at 1080p, and setting the presets high to low didn't make too much of a difference for some reason here. So probably just a the way the game kind of supports ARM, Windows 11 ARM here. Maybe that's an issue there. Probably in the future update, this will be fixed. But currently, it didn't make too much of a difference setting the settings here. So just going on high at 1080p, running the benchmark, you'll see what kind of score we get here and the average FPS. And here we can go ahead and see the frames rendered, and the average FPS is 30. The one thing that really stands out on this laptop is the OLED monitor. The blacks are perfect, as you would expect from an OLED. And the colors definitely pop out, and with its 600 nits when we're on like HDR, it looks pretty great. So I'm just gonna go ahead and play it here. You can kind of get an idea. So even though right now the room is pretty bright, you can see my reflection here, but when you're getting a picture there, like it looks super clear. Definitely the colors look really good. And I don't think the camera is doing it justice of how good this looks. And there are some settings you can go ahead and play around with, like with my ASUS app. If you go under device settings here, if you go under audio video, you're able to go ahead and set a few things up here. So we have normal, vivid, manual. So you're able to set a few things up here. And when it comes to an OLED monitor, I don't think you should be afraid of things burning in, because you have these things kind of like pixel refresh. That's you should definitely leave this on. So once in a while, it will do its pixel refresh. So you're not really going to get a burn in, like unless you're leaving something non-stop on the monitor, something like an icon that's the same, then probably that's gonna go ahead and be a problem. But overall, the picture quality looks great on this. So let's talk about battery life on this Vivobook S15. When it comes time to setting the laptop under power efficiency, I was able to stretch out around 13 hours, so 10 to 13 hours. And that's like with light browsing and watching a video here and there. And once you go ahead and set it to balanced or performance, that number cut in half and even less sometimes. One thing to notice is if you're gonna set the laptop under performance, it tends to heat up in the middle here and around the back here in the middle area, that's where the CPU is. Even on some light tasks under performance mode, it tends up to heat up pretty quickly, so it gets a little bit toasty here. But under power efficiency mode, the laptop stays super cool all around in the back as well. And the fan noise, you kind of have to put your ear like near here just to go ahead and hear the fan, which is good as well. First thing I did once I set up the laptop under the My ASUS app, if you go under system updates, this is the version that I had to update to. So that's the Qualcomm, and it's a hotfix, and version 1.307. We're gonna go ahead and do a teardown, and then we'll see what we're able to upgrade or not on this laptop here. So we're gonna have to remove these screws here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay, we got all the screws out, and you're gonna have to use one of these if you just wanna kind of make it quicker, just to take the cover off. So kind of the best way that I found to remove the cover is go ahead and kind of pull this portion up a little bit, then this comes off super easy. And then just kind of put your hands in and just pull up. You're not gonna really break anything. It's, you have to apply a little force, but then it just comes off. And here we have the cover, some mesh there so dust does not get in. And inside here we have two fans that we can see, and I can already see a full-size NVMe drive, which is great. One thing is the Wi-Fi 7 is not replaceable. And here we have our 70 watt hour battery, so it's taking a big chunk of space here. And then we got the right and the left speaker, so that's kind of facing towards you whenever you're playing anything. And some Wi-Fi antennas here as well, so it's going all around. Next, we're gonna go ahead and remove the top here. Really hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you found it helpful, go ahead and leave a like. Also, if you are new here, go ahead and click that subscribe button. If you have any questions or any tests that you want me to run on this new Snapdragon X Elite laptop, go ahead and leave a comment below. I'll be more than happy to do that. Also, I will be putting the video links in the description below for the teardown and the test with the liquid metal paste here. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next video.